Rahul Behao, Ahe Ata Antom. This is Murhuta, Nudimu E Kahagadu El, and this is Sanu 74, which is Sabadin Arbed, Shahur Shu, Yawom Nudimut. Alright, so I said that's the year 74, the month of Shu, which is the fourth month, and the Nuwabe Tagwom, and it is the day of Nudimut. And that's in the first week. So that would be Wa Uspu. So, again, I'm coming back to you guys on a recorded line here. The last audio I made was about the Chaldeans, and I was reading out of a book called The Black Chaldeans and the Cushite Seed of People of the Tigris and Euphrates Rivers, or Euphrates Valleys, excuse me, by John Brinson. And just to do away with all the black devils, and we know the Caucasoid ones, but the black devils, it's kind of hard to see. So we're going to read out of this brother's book again. His name is John Brinson. Look it up on Amazon. He got some real good stuff about the spawning of the Sumerian culture. He does say that the Sumerian culture came out of Egypt. But I wanted to highlight a couple of excerpts here I want to read. Alright. Okay, so we're going to start on page 54. It says, the Sumerians were non-Semitic, non-Indo-European people who lived in southern Babylonia from 3500 to 2000 BCE. Their spiritual beliefs influenced all successive Near Eastern religions, including Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. They produced an extensive body of literature. Among the oldest in the world, they have their genesis amongst the ancient Ethiopians. We must keep in the forefront of our minds the fact that the Sumerian culture domination of the entire area lasted for approximately 1500 years. And I know he says that it started from 3500 BC to 2000, but they found artifacts and relics and steles and reliefs going back like to like 6000 BC. So his dates might be a little off. It was the Sumerians who represented the dominant culture group of the entire Near East. It was the Sumerians who probably invented the cuneiform system of writing, who developed a well-integrated pantheon together with spiritual and religious concepts, which influenced profoundly all the peoples of the Near East. Finally, created and developed literature rich in content and effective in content. During the period of approximately 4000 BC, when the former cave dwellers were at the borders of Egypt, grazing their domesticated cattle and trading with our people, we made that fatal mistake that still affects us as a people today by opening our doors of hospitality to them in antiquity, and are still reaping the consequences of that life-altering decision. However, it was approximately 1700 BC before they overthrew the Egyptians and ruled the country for about 150 years, or until the famed 18th dynasty of Nubian pharaohs who kicked them out of office and seized their political control. Now, the brother John Brinson says that they took over the whole country. They actually didn't take over the whole country. They took over a section of Tamaray, right? Because he's still using the word Egyptian. But we know that from Dr. Malachi Z. York that the country was vast. It wasn't just Northeast Africa. It was going over basically the whole entire North Africa and Arabia, or at least Southern Arabia, what they're calling Arabia today, which is really the land of Kedar, which is the land basically black people. So that's just one correction or one suggestion I would suggest that the whoever listens to this take note of. The Sumerians, however, were initially composed of a colony of Neolithic Negroes, followers and practitioners of the Stellar Cult, who migrated from the Nile Valley to this extreme area of Northeast Africa, to the Euphrates and Tigris valleys, and began civilization there. So, you know, Neolithic means anybody living along the Nile valleys. That's what the Tamahu says. To add the power of truth behind any claims about Sumer being an extension of African origins, I shall first highlight the fact that even the ancient Sumerians referred to themselves as the black-headed people. All right, so let's stop right there. One of the reasons why I'm reading this, you know what I mean? I'm reading this for people who are interested, because we have some of our own family saying that Sumerians are basically Caucasians. And it's not coming from Tamahus, it's coming from Moors, it's coming from other black people. So I'm like, how does that make sense? When do you start going against the facts? I thought only Tamahus did that, but now we're seeing some of our own people, black people, Negro, proper title would be Moor, but you know, they're starting to destroy themselves. So that's why I read this, so you have the evidence and the facts that yes, the Sumerians were Moors. Yes, the original Akkadians were Moors. Yes, the first Amalites were Moors before the Russians came in. You know what I'm saying? All these people were Moors. So that's why I read it. Alright, let's continue on here. Where was that? Okay. How can anyone call these people liars about who they say and demonstrate to you they are? And there is no doubt that the oldest and most exalted deity of the Sumerians was Anu, a name that loudly reflects black populations at the dawn of history, including Egypt itself, the Arabian Peninsula, India, and even Europe and other places. Archaeologists such as Petrie saw in the Anu an ancient group of Negroid civilizers moving into the Nile Valley from the east, perhaps from Mesopotamia via Arabia. Equally important is the skeletal evidence exhumed from ancient Sumerian cemeteries. Also, the biblical references in which Nimrod, the Old Testament founder of Sumer, is described as a son of Cush, Ethiopia. The architectural similarities, eyewitness accounts, and other oral traditions. Herbert Wendt is honest enough to confess the following conclusions he reached after many years of research and study of the subject matter. Alright, so here's what Herbert got to say, y'all. This is what he had to say. Check it out. Sumerian civilization disappeared under waves of Semitic, Akkadians, and Amorite, Assyrians, and Babylonians, Hittites, Arameans, Kassites, Medes, Persians, and Alexandrian Greeks, along with a host of other cultures. But the Sumerians did not disappear. Even today, their descendants live on, a dark-skinned group in the populations of hither Asia, and their arts and inventions remain also. Their building technique, their script, their cylindrical seals, their laws, and religious works. Later invaders, right up to Herodotus' time, took over the culture that the mythical Oannes introduced. Assyria and Nineveh, Mitanni, the Hittite kingdom, Phoenicia, Israel, and the navel of the world, Great Babylon, all rose into being on the foundation laid by the Sumerians. So, we can rest assured that the Sumerians were Moors. They were dark-skinned, woolly-haired people. So, see any contest to that, except by races, Tomahawks, and Black Devils. Okay, just keep it moving, Nuwabian. The truth can be denied and replaced with hypothetical pretensions to distract from that truth for centuries, but eventually light flashes for a moment on the truth and is illumined for a moment or so. But some quick-thinking Afrikoid mind grabs it and brings it into discourse with the left and right side of the brain. It is eventually shared with the world, and a new interest in the subject comes into being. All right, so I'm gonna stop right there, and I just wanted to share that with y'all about. Oh yeah, but the Sumerians. Actually, I want to read one more part. This is going back to the beginning of the chapter called Sumerians Blackheads. Alright, it says, over 5,000 years ago, before Babylon existed, the Sumerians were building their high temples everywhere in the southern region between the Tigris and the Euphrates. They brought civilization to Northeast Africa, mistakenly called the Middle East, from the Nile Valley. It was sometime during the second half of the 4th millennium BC that they arrived in the fertile plain of the Tigris and the Euphrates, and referring to themselves as Blackheads. Dr. John G. Jackson confirms the growing belief that these Blackhead Sumerians occupied ancient Mesopotamia and were the earliest to bring civilization to this area. Dr. John G. Jackson claims these Blackhead Sumerians occupied ancient Mesopotamia and were the earliest civilizers of this area. See, y'all were civilizers, not the civilized. This appears very credible since it substantiates biblical scripture, which also informs us black people, Nimrod and his crew, founded the civilization of Sumer. Check Genesis 10, 8 through 10. Before the Chaldean rule in Mesopotamia, there were the empires of the Sumerians, Akkadians, Babylonians, and Assyrians. The earliest civilization of Mesopotamia was that of the Sumerians. They are designated in the Assyrio-Babylonian inscriptions as the Blackhead or Blackface people, and they are shown on the monuments as beardless and with shaven heads. So, just more proof, more icing on the cake for the black devil out there that's saying that Sumerians are Adamites, which Adamites is not a race either. But I think they're inferring that they're Caucasians, which is false. So they are us and we are them. We are their, I don't think we're their direct descendants, but we are of the same race, which means we are the same genes. Maybe a little altered, but we come from the same root. So, you know, keep that in mind when you got to approach the black devil about who the Sumerians were. So I'm going to go ahead and end it with that, and I'll talk to y'all probably next week. Wadoo.